Hello and welcome to another episode of Greymouse Does Stuff. In this tutorial, we are going to be looking at transferring disk images for a Commodore 64. We will be using this compact desktop PC, which is connected to a Commodore 64 disk drive via the parallel cable using a basic X1541 cable, which is connected to the parallel port to the back of my PC. I've included a schematic for the X1541 cable that I'm using, as well as some useful links, but that will be coming up soon in the video. Right here is my parallel port. It is an integrated parallel port. It's part of the motherboard, and this is the DB25 male end of the cable. So look, so there you can see the pins. That's male. And parallel port, you can sort of see that. Follow the cable back to the 64 disk drive. Just turn the drive around. This is the back, and as you can see there, it is plugged in to the serial port using this 6-pin DIN, which is on the other end of the parallel cable. Time to check out the demo we will be transferring. So this is a demo disk which is running currently on my 64, and yes, it's the for some odd reason that the composite out is black and white on here. But I just wanted to show you that the demo is up and running after being transferred using the PC. Let's start by having a look at the schematics for the X1541 cable, as well as the software needed to transfer disk images back and forth. Initial setup. Here's a better picture of the drive that we'll be using. It's a 5¼ Commodore 1541-2 floppy disk drive. This will be connected to the PC. Let's have a look at the back. Before we start anything else, we need to ensure that this floppy drive is set to device 8. As you can see, under the word device, there are two switches, and those two switches need to be set according to the manual. Now, if we look in the manual, it says that drive 8, switch 1 is on, and switch 2 is on. If it's not set to this, use a flathead screwdriver and flick those two switches upwards. Once you have those two set, the drive is ready to go. Let's check out the pin layout for the cable. There's a variety of different cables which will work with the program Star Commander. What we're looking at here is the parallel port end of a X1541 cable my dad made me some time ago. the most basic cable that you can get. Okay, let's look into how to make this cable. It's a male DB25. Here's the pinout for the parallel port end. I've also included the original website for the schematics of this cable. If you'd like to have a look at the other cables which are available, the schematics are on there. Now, looking at the other end of the cable, which plugs into the drive itself, it's the 6-pin DIN plug. Here are the schematics. Again, please have a look at that website. It's got lots of useful information. Finally, here is the complete schematics for both the parallel port end and the 6-pin DIN end. Once you have the cable made, plug in the parallel cable into the parallel port on the back of your PC and plug in the 6-pin DIN into your Commodore drive. Make sure you plug it into the serial port and that the device is set to 8 and that you've got the power connected. Okay, let's have a look at the PC. Here's a folder I have created, and I've put in multiple D64 disk image files. We're going to be using a copy of Star Commander 0.8. I've created a bootable disk and I've copied the Star Commander files onto it. It's ready to go as well. Star Commander comes with some documentation. Let's have a look at the text file. This documentation comes with the zip file. I'll quickly just go through and highlight the important bits. Here's the introduction. This is a list of supported custom-made cables that will work with this version of Star Commander. Now we get a little bit more technical. What this is saying is if your parallel port on your computer has only EPP or ECP support in the BIOS, then you have to have another type of cable. Later in this video, I will show you how to access your PC's BIOS and check that setting. The following disk drives are supported by Star Commander. For this video, I will be using my 15412 drive. Again, this is referring to the parallel port settings in the BIOS for the type of cable that I am using. Here's a pinout for both the DB25 and the 6-pin DIN connector. And this is a text version of the diagram that I showed you earlier for the X1541 cable. On the left we have the DIN plug, and on the right we have the parallel port cable. Starting from the Commodore side, pin 2 goes to ground, pin 3 goes to pin 1, pin 4 goes to pin 14, pin 5 goes to pin 17, and pin 6 goes to pin 16. This is just the basic cable. This is a list of credits for people who were involved in creating the cable and the software that I'm using. Here is a list of useful links. The complete documentation comes with the zip file that you download for the Star Commander program. That was a summary of the documentation. That's the end of this part of the video. All the hardware required is ready to go. The drive is connected to my PC. The cable has been made. The next part is the software side. Let's look at that now. Star Commander doesn't work properly under Windows, or at least under this version of Windows. If we start it up, it throws up this particular warning message. Not particularly useful. Because of this, I have created a boot disk which will run this program under DOS instead. On the disk, I have included a utility to allow me to read my NTFS partition on my C drive. Now the boot disk is ready. Let's reboot and configure the BIOS. In this part, we're going to be looking at the BIOS settings for the parallel port. If you remember in the documentation, it had some specific requirements as to what the settings ought to be. We're going to have a look at this now. How do you get into the BIOS? Basically, when you power up your PC, there will be a message on the lower right-hand side of your screen saying which key you need to tap repeatedly to get into the BIOS. It's usually the delete key, or F10, or F9, something like that. But there will be a message when you start up your computer to press this key to access the BIOS. In my case, it's F10. If you've done it correctly, you should get a menu on the screen, or you should get a menu similar to this one. This compact computer has an integrated parallel port, which means that it is on the motherboard. You may have a parallel port which is on a card, but you'll need to look at the back of the PC. All we need to do is change the parallel port settings for your PC. In the case of this Compaq, it is under the Advanced drop-down menu. Onboard devices, since it's a integrated parallel port. This parallel port's I/O address is set to 37837A, that's standard. So that's fine. Now we go down to device options. This is the most important screen. As you can see here, the printer mode is set to bi-directional, and according to the Star Commander documentation, the older type of cable, which I'm using, the X1541, works with either SSPP or PS2 or a bidirectional printer mode. And it also says that the other printer modes like EPP plus ECP won't work with the cable that I am using. So for me, I'll put it onto bidirectional. If you have options for SPP or PS2 in your BIOS settings, then you can use those settings. So bidirectional is the mode that I'll use. Again, all this information is in the Star Commander documentation, so if you're lost, Just have a look at that text file. Once you've set it to the right mode, we'll save the settings and start firing stuff up. In summary, the Commodore disk drive is set up and the BIOS is set up correctly. Powering up the drive. The drive should start spinning. Restart the Windows PC. And let it boot off the floppy disk. Yes, that is a rubber band because the latch is kaputsky. So this is the little utility I was talking about earlier, which allows you to read NTFS volumes while in DOS. Pretty cool. The bootable disk was successful and it has detected my C drive. Let's check the contents of this bootable disk. Change directory to the hard disk. We'll go into the Commodore 64 folder, which I showed you earlier in the video. Right, those D64 files are disk images. For now, we'll go back to the A drive, where the Star Commander program is located. What's next? Well, we will have to start up Star Commander and see if it will detect the Commodore drive using our custom cable and to see if the parallel port settings in the BIOS are okay. If everything works out, it should go. The main thing we're looking out here for is whether or not the disk drive itself will start reading the disk when the program starts. If it does that, then that's a good start. That's what you want. The green light's going. This is the main screen. On the left hand side of the screen, it has loaded the Commodore 64 disk drive under drive 8, and the PC side, which is drive A. Because I've used this program before, it has saved the previous settings for the drives. So it's already configured to pick up my Commodore drive. If the Commodore drive that you're using hasn't shown up either on the left or on the right, you'll need to change some settings. Let's do that now. Press F9 to bring up a toolbar, use the left arrow key to go to the left drop down menu and select drive. This will bring up a pop-up window asking you which drive you would like to use. Remember how we set both those switches up at the beginning of this video? That sets it to 8, so select 8. If everything is set up correctly and the cable is okay, you should see the disk drive's disk contents. Look at some of the options. So press F9. No, we don't want any of those at the moment. Those we'll use later. For now, we will start with the configuration setup. Now, these settings work for me, so with a bit of luck, if you just duplicate the settings that I have here on your PC, it will also work. Other options. Image file options. And the all important transfer options. Because these settings are important, what I'll do is I will put the documentation side by side so we can go through each of the options. Transfer mode, it's best to use warp speed because it's the most fastest and most reliable for the cable that I'm using. The serial cable selection is set to X1541. We're not using a parallel cable, we're using a serial connection, so that's set to none. force async transfer. Leave this disabled for plain DOS. Delay value is determined by the CPU load and speed, but 4 seems to be okay. Set both the parallel and serial interface to LPT1. Detect port modes will bring up any error messages, if there is any. And the drive type is 1541 because that's the drive I've got connected to the PC. If it's something else, you'll have to change that option to another drive type. Later in the video, I will go through the disk copy options. But this is probably the most important settings. If warp speed doesn't work for you, I would recommend to you try turbo. Sometimes turbo is fast enough for the disk image to be transferred successfully. So try either warp or turbo, or even normal if that doesn't work either, I guess. Drive options. So this is the final configuration screen I'm going to look at. All the options that have been set in the other configuration screens seem to work for me. So hopefully if you use the same settings, it will work for you as well. That's all we need to configure. So go down to exit and it will save the changes. So the next time you start up Star Commander, it should automatically load up the Commodore drive. Time to test a disk image transfer. With all the options that we've set, you should see the Commodore drive 8 on the left and the disk drive on the right. Alright, let's transfer the demo disk image over to the blank floppy disk. Let's go to the C drive. That's the one. See if I can find that file. There it is. Press enter. And this will show you the contents of the disk image. And we can scroll all the way down to the bottom. And up again. Let's transfer this disk image. First, we back out and go back to the drive and go back to the disk image. With the disk image highlighted, go to F9, go over to commands and select copy disk. These are the default options. We would like to format the blank disk, and we're also going to use a full disk copy. In case you're wondering what a BAM disk copy is, I'll explain a little bit about the file system. The block availability map, or BAM, basically tells DOS which sectors are being used by what programs and files. It also keeps track of how free space there is available left on the disk. If you do a BAM disk copy, it will only copy the used sectors of the disk. For now, I'll stick with the full disk copy. Press enter, and it's starting with the formatting. We'll copy the disk image onto the Commodore drive. On the top left, we get the 64 drive is busy formatting. There is a little bit of a delay between the transfer and format. And the transfer method is set to turbo. That's why it's going so quickly. It's finished. It will do a directory of the disk. And that's it. That is the triad demo copied over to the C64 floppy disk using the cable and a drive. It's ready to run on a real Commodore 64. Next up, we'll make a disk image out of this particular disk So we'll write it back to a D64 file. Open up the drive where we would like to store the disk image. And we're going to select drive A. After that, we need to go to the left hand side to the Commodore disk. Press tab to switch between the two. Now the Commodore disk is highlighted. Let's make a disk image out of it. Go F9, commands, copy disk. It's prompting us for a file name. We have to add the extension D64 as well. We'll also be using full disk copy. Starts by creating a disk image from the floppy which is in the Commodore drive. Just let that go. It's done. Here's the disk image ready to be used in an emulator. To sum it all up, we have converted a Commodore 64 disk image back onto an original Commodore disk. And then we created a disk image from the Commodore drive back to the PC. I'll take this disk and run it on my 64. It's working. Part 2. Looking at the Star Commander documentation. I think it would be interesting to show you the help pages which are within the Star Commander program itself and do a side-by-side comparison between each configuration screens and what the options mean. For the purposes of this tutorial, I will be concentrating on the transfer options window and the copy disk options. We'll be right back.
We'll be right back. Thank you.
now the copy disk menu and the manual for the various options you see here.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Congrats, you've made it to the end of my video. Well done. I hope it didn't bore you. Thank you very much for watching. I hope you found this tutorial useful. Please feel free to like this video and share it. Bye. Yo 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 y